We left off 8:24. We're just in the middle of the third paragraph. He had spoken about taking control, disciplining your senses, your mind, your eyes, your ears, what you speak, what you touch, where you go. Now we speak, how do you take control of your thoughts and your emotions and your feelings? How do you take control of that? אבל הפרי של רגש בפונם השלישים, but the abstinence which has relevance to the third thing that we discussed, והוא מה שישחייך יתבונו במצמנינו מחשבותינו, which is specifically relevant to what's within us and within our minds, ויצרי לבבינו, our inclinations, הטוב והרועים, our good inclinations, our bad inclinations. Firstly, to address this, what do you have to abstain from? You have to remove all the aspirations for the acquisitions, the material acquisitions of this world, your ambition. You want to succeed materially. That ambition of material success has to be out of, and cannot be part of your mindset. The only reason why you want to earn and succeed is only to have enough to sustain yourself. Nothing more than that. And it's not for the sake of pleasure. To give pleasure to the body, and not to achieve and accomplish comfort and acclaim. No, you want to be a leader in your field. You want to be recognized as a successful person. You want to have the acclaim of your peers. That cannot be part of, because if that's the case, there's no end to it. Because then you can be preoccupied, because that is your ambition. Yeah, okay. But it's within a mitzvah context. I'll give you an example. Remember the first time I learned Maseches Ksubos, I was 13 years old. So we skipped the beginning of the Maseches. This is way back, and because they felt if a young boy at that age studying this is not appropriate. But even when you're older, when you study it, you're 17 years old. Even though you're discussing cohabitation and parts of the physicality of a woman, because it's studied with the Torah, it doesn't cause want to think about other things within a sexual context. You don't think about it in that. So I'm saying, what I have to provide for my wife, why? It's a mitzvah, right? I have to have a different menu on Shabbos than I eat during the week. There's a famous story of Yosef Haim Zonnefeld, who was a Kaddish. He was the Rav of the old community of Yerushalayim. So his wife passed away, so when he remarried, and his new wife, was the Rebbetzin of some Hasidic Rebbe. And, you know, she was used to, you know, she accommodated Rebbes like a prince. He was a man, he was the farthest thing from material. He walks in the middle of the week, he smells chicken soup. He smells chicken being roasted. Whatever. Even Shabbos, he partook of that to a very minimal level. During the week, was bare subsistence. I mean, that was the Yosef Haim Zonnefeld. That's where he lived his life. So what is he? He's going to hurt her feelings. She's going to be married. She doesn't understand really who he is. She says, you know, everything smells delicious, this and that, but you realize if we have this during the week, so what makes Shabbos special? What makes Shabbos special? We want Shabbos to be special. We should enjoy it. And it's a whole different experience, Shabbos. But if we have it during the week, the chicken and the soup and there, so why Shabbos is not normally as special as it could be. So good. So when you have that special food, which is tastier, more enjoyable, is it to indulge? Shabbos is your chance to indulge. It's not your chance to indulge. There's a beautiful word from Sfas Emes. It says that Shemini Atzeres, spoke with Sfas Emes yesterday, but this one is an understandable, easy Sfas Emes to understand. So he says, Shemini Atzeres, one Yom Tov is basically 7 days. What Shemini Atzeres is 8 days. Why don't we have an extra day? So the Medrash says, and also we have that during the 7 days, multiple communal components are brought. Oxen. Shemini Atzeres only one. So, Kodesh Baruch Hu says, so the Medrash says, what is it now? Was two. A person has an intimate friend, very close, the person's a king, and he invites all the people who are more distant from him to the banquet, and he doesn't invite his friend, his closest friend, the king. So the friend says to the king, I feel offended. And here we're so close, you invite all these strangers, or people who are not that close with you, and me, you don't invite. He says, you don't understand. I'm reserving the last day just for you, just the two of us. Nobody else is going to be there. And the Medrash says, Asu bishvili suda katana. Make for me a small meal. So the Sfas Emes, what do you mean a small meal? Asu bishvili suda. What's with the suda katana? He explains it with a mushroom, with an alimony. He says, yeah, these country bumpkins, these villagers, and they get an invitation to the inaugural ball of the king. So what's the first thing that comes to mind? Endless wine, food, delicacies, things they never eat. We'll really be able to really enjoy ourselves. One of a kind of a banquet. The more sophisticated person says, he says, I have an opportunity to meet the king. The food is only the setting where you're going to meet the king. Asa b'shvili suda ketana, it's not the suda. It's not the meal. That's only the setting to be able to have the relationship. That's the suda ketana. Understand? The food itself, that I have special food on Shabbos is not to have the special food on Shabbos. Because now I have a chance to enjoy myself. It's because the day is special, therefore you have to honor the day with special food. It's a whole different, the emphasis is different emphasis. It's not the physical desire to have special food. Now, there's a story with the, Sfas Emes is a story, that there was this chosid, and the Rebbe takes an apple, and says, Borei for eight, and bites into the apple. Sfas Emes, chosid sees the Rebbe doing this, takes the apple, kavona, and he says, Borei for eight, and bites into the apple. So after the Rebbe, first he sees the chosid, you know, trying to emulate him, he says, what I want to explain to you is me and you. He says, I'm only eating the apple to be able to say the bracha. You're eating the apple to eat the apple, so you said the bracha to permit you to eat the apple. That's the difference between me and you. I want to acknowledge Hashem for creating the apple, so I have to eat the apple to acknowledge it. See, that's the difference between the two of us. So don't think you're me. That's what the Sfas Emes told his chassid. The same thing. So again, what should the person's focus? It shouldn't be letanugei haguf. It's not to be dissatisfied the desire of the body, the physical desires, the physical cravings. That's not the reason. To be.
So, once the body is physically satisfied to a higher level, then the person as a whole is knowledge and appreciation.
So that I mentioned the Orach Chaim HaKadosh in Minei Lekodesh, he brings his Zohar. That any part of the body that you do a mitzvah with is a special shmira, that physical pleasure should not lead you to something which is negative. Because he speaks about cohabitation. Kedoshim Tiyu. Why this? See, he speaks specifically about that. See, he quotes the Zohar. That the Aver receives a Kedusha. Even the act. And as a result of that, you protect it from many other things. Does not draw it to other things. Yeah, of course, the kavanah is, but still, but simultaneously, physically, you eat food, you have taste buds, right? You have pleasure.
Some people say because they eat, that they want to eat because they want to sustain.
But it's, you can say what you want. You know, the question is where you're at. You know, whatever you want to say over there.
Well, we can't say that it's just the food in and of itself. It's like, now look at this high delicacy food that the person doesn't like and doesn't appreciate. He's not going to get any benefit from eating it. He's not going to have any effect. It's actually food that he enjoys, which will enable him to go to a higher level and to enable him to appreciate the food.
Oh, it's only Shabbos. Certain food you have an allergic reaction, of course you don't eat that food.
I'm allergic, it doesn't like.
So you don't eat it?
No,
the pizza is onik. It doesn't make a difference, but it's onik. But it doesn't mean it shouldn't be on your table if you have other people there.
Right, I'm just saying.
You're right, 100%.
Everybody enjoys because that will enable him to go to our.